Hey everyone, Turf Teacher here. I'll give a few seconds to see if anybody jumps on. Probably not, but maybe there'll be a few people on. At least there's no good NCAA tournament games on tonight. But what I wanted to talk to you tonight about was the difference between a free estimate and a bid or a consultation. And I want to start by saying that, guys, there's really no such thing as a free estimate. If you have a residential customer call and you show up to their job, you know, to their property, and you walk around with them and you take pictures and you take measurements, you're still spending your time and spending your energy and effort being there, whereas you could be somewhere actually making money. So what kind of got me interested on this topic was last night we had a call from a potential client. Last night, it was after hours, we still answered the phone, but they wanted to know if we could come by and give them a free estimate and design. That was her exact words. Can I get a free estimate and design? And I'm like, absolutely not. I said, if you have a design, I would be more than happy to bid the job for you. But if I come out and I walk around the yard, I spend time with you, I'm gonna have to charge a consultation fee. Well, that's not a free estimate. No, a free estimate is when a residential client actually has a landscape drawing, a plan either drawn by a landscape architect or a landscape designer that you can drive by, pick up a copy of the plans, maybe do a little site visit, go back to your office and do a takeoff. You're actually going to submit a bid or proposal to do the installation. Because what I'm seeing is people have no idea of what they want. They want you to come out to their yard, walk around with you. They want to take your ideas, and then they're going to be like, well, price it for me. Well, it's hard to do that. It's hard to go back to your office, sit down, and come up with an estimate for something that they want. They don't even know what they want. So you actually have to have a plan. So when people call, we tell them straight up, we have a consultation fee to walk around, meet with you, however you need. It's a per hour fee. Now, if you have a landscape design that's drawn by a professional, either an architect or designer, we will bid it for you. That's no charge. I can go back to the shop and I can do a quantity takeoff and give you an estimate probably the same day. I just know how to bid plans because everything is there for me. And when I'm bidding against a colleague, it's apples for apples. The designers specified everything. They usually got the type of brick paver. They've got the type of plants. They've got the type of water feature. They've got the type of fire pit. Whatever is on the plan, it's spec'd out, and you can estimate that job for you. So that is where the free estimate comes into play, is when there is a landscape drawing for you to do the bid from. There's no way that I'm actually going to go and walk around the yard with someone, spend an hour and a half, 2 hours walking around their yard. Hey, Eric, what is this plant here? You know, I've had it for 10 years. I don't know why it hasn't bloomed. Well, for one, it's a compacta holly. That's why it's not blooming. But you walk around and you give this information. Next thing you know, you've wasted an hour, 2 hours. And then they're like, well, I really don't know what I want to do. We'll be back in touch with you. So you've killed 2 hours, guys. You got to let them know up front that you charge whatever you set your hourly rate for. You need to let them know up front that you will charge for a consultation. Now, if you wanted to credit them that consultation feedback, if you get the job, that's totally up to you. And that could be a selling point. So that they feel like they're not actually, wasting their money. So you've got to be able to let them know up front that you charge for your time. Time is the most valuable thing that you have. So any of you guys have any questions on how to possibly bid some of these things? What we're running into a lot is we're seeing way crazy prices when it comes to either a mulch or a pine needle job. So what are you guys out there seeing when it comes to that? And do you guys actually charge for a consultation fee? And if so, if you don't mind telling me, what are you guys getting per hour? Let's see, there's four of you guys on right now. Guys, our minimum fee is $85 an hour for consultation. That's to show up, walk around, and it's if I spend 30 minutes or if I spend an hour there, I'm gonna charge them $85. If I run over into the second hour, I'm gonna charge them another $85. And I let them know up front on the phone. So That may be a little less than you guys. That may be a little bit more than you guys, but you've got to get something for your time to show up and consult with them. It's a different story. Like I said, if they have the landscape plan drawn by an architect or by a designer, be glad to pick up a set of plans and price the job for you, with a pretty quick turnaround. I mean, I can figure a typical residential site in a couple hours. I mean, we've just done so many of them, even a commercial job. We've done so many O'Reilly Auto Parts. We've done so many Dollar Tree stores. I mean, these things are just on and on. If it's a consult and talking about a design, it's $95 per hour. So good price there, Pierce. Where are you guys located, Pierce? Are y'all in North Carolina? Pierce Landcare. Are you guys in Raleigh? Okay, good deal. So yeah, man, that's a good price for it. And $75. Pine needle and mulch prices are a killer around here. Same here, man. We got guys going around, and I never price a pine needle job per bale. That drives me crazy, because our customers saying, "Well, how much do you charge per bale?" I'm like, I will not price it per bale. We price it per job. Cool, you guys are in Wilson. I price it per job. And guys, we're starting to see, I mean, we're getting $12 a bale. For one, I'm spending $4.50 on a bale of pine needles. By the time I go and pick them up, I've got $5 in the bale. And the time I get back to the job site, spread the needles, do the cleanup, edge to edge or whatever, I'm going to charge $12 a bale. But I'm never going to let the client know that. I'm never going to tell them what I charge that. I'm going to figure the square footage. I'm going to figure out how many bales I need, and I'm going to multiply it. And I'm going to say, hey, pine needle installation will be X amount of dollars. There's not even going to be a quantity on the pine needles, because you might tell the client that you're putting out 20 bales, and you show up with the 20 bales and you have a bale left over. Next thing you want to know, they want to start deducting that. So no, it's a price per install of the pine needles. I do not do a price per bale. You guys pricing it per bale, or are you doing it per job? And the one thing I don't like including if I'm on a 12-month payment from a commercial client, if it's a large commercial job, I'm not going to include that in the 12-month price, because what I've actually seen, if you price pine needling a job twice for a customer, good deal, Zach. Price per job 90% of the time. So you guys are right on track. And I don't like including it in the 12-month contract. I want to bill that separately. So I'll do a 12-month contract, for the customers and take 12 monthly payments if it's for, the plugging and seeding, mowing, spraying, the pruning, all that. But I will leave the mulch and the pine straw out. I don't even want that included, because that's the first thing they want you to do when you take over a new contract. They want you to go ahead and get it cleaned up perfectly. They want everything pruned, and they want everything pine needled or mulched as soon as you take over. Well, then it's going to take 3 or 4 months for you to get your money back for the pine straw and mulch. So do that separate. Let them know up front, hey, here's your 12-month contract price. These are the services that include. And if you want pine needles or mulch, and when you want it, it'll be X amount of dollars. And we've had luck with that. I mean, people aren't saying no to that. And they kind of understand when you explain it from a business standpoint. So I'm glad to see you guys are doing it per job as well. How many of you guys are actively bidding hardscape jobs right now? Any of that going on? I've actually bid a couple here in the last week. And tell the people up front, what it's going to cost per square foot, what we're getting for that.
I don't know.
And
that
sorry, Alexa's talking to me as well. And they kind of freak out a little bit. But when you explain to them what the costs are, I mean, that is a very, very difficult thing for people to comprehend what it costs to do those. Any questions for me? They're what about seeding? You got a new yard that you're seeding. Clients built a house. You got bare ground. What are you guys getting per square foot on new seed install or sod? Know of anyone that needs a summer job or full time job in Raleigh, Durham? Pierce, not right now. My students that are graduating in May, I think graduation's May 12th. All of my students have jobs waiting on them. As soon as they graduate, guys, to get in front of the community college students, you guys need to be contacting me in August and September when the students start their second year, because that's when they really start to think about, hey, I'm going to work when I graduate. So, you know, Pierce, contact me, Zach, contact me, guys, at the beginning of the school year in August. You know, I'd love for you guys to connect with the students early on, because they start thinking about it in August, September. Hey, you know, I graduate this year, so I need to start looking. And they find their jobs. All of them find their jobs before the Christmas break. Follow me at FT Horticulture. That's Forsyth Tech Horticulture. That's the Instagram page. Most of the students, we just started that page last week. The college is wanting all of the programs to be on the social media. I think it's great. And so I'm trying to get all the students on FT Horticulture, and that'll give you a direct link with them. And so when we start posting student projects and the students start commenting, that'll give some two-way conversations with you guys and direct messages. What do you want on my end to help them learn more about what I do in my company? Pierce, follow us on the FT Horticulture Instagram. We've got the Twitter page, FT Horticulture, Instagram, Facebook, Snapchat. All of those are FT Horticulture. I'm waiting on enough subscribers on the YouTube page so that I can name the YouTube page FT Horticulture. But like I said, we just got that started last week, and it'll take some time to actually build that up. And when the students start getting on there, you guys will have direct access. But if you guys want to send me a job description or a job posting that you have, you can send it to the school email address. That's ejones at forsythtech.edu. That's Forsythtech, forsythtech.edu. And it's ejones for Eric Jones, ejones at forsythtech.edu. If you can send me a job description or a job posting that you had, I'll be glad to put that on the job board and just make sure it's got good contact information on there for you. As far as the long term, what is your opinion on residential versus commercial markets? Everyone say they want to do one or the other, or I hear guys saying they don't like one or the other. I like them both. I like the small residential yards to work for, and then I like working for the commercial builders. I don't like working for residential home builders. That sometimes takes a little longer to get your money. The commercial builders, I know that it's going to take 60 to 90 days to get paid from those guys, but it's guaranteed money because the contracts are so guaranteed and they're so secure. And we've had a lot of good luck working for the commercial builders. It's the single family home builders, and I still consider that commercial because you're actually working for a contractor. But I don't like the working for the residential builder. I'd much rather work for the larger builders because I know I'm gonna get the money. It's just gonna take a little bit longer. But I mean, you could go 6 months. Sometimes we've gone 6 months on a residential builder waiting to get paid. For some reason, they get tied up. They've got a house that's sitting. They're going to make that interest payment before they pay the landscaper. But I love commercial, and then I love working for the individual homeowner themselves. So That's totally up to you, man. And it's separate. It really is. To do commercial landscape installations for the large builders, and I'm talking about the guys that build the Targets, that build the restaurants, that build auto parts stores and those things, you've got to have a crew that's really dedicated and set up to do that, because to be honest with you, man, they're going to call you a couple days and say, I need you here, you know, the next day. Even though you kind of know the schedule, they're going to want you in there before that time frame. You know, we've showed up to many job sites where, like, guys, we don't even need to be here. You're not ready for us. But we've planted trees on site that doesn't even have, you know, the paving done yet. So it depends on what you want to do. And it's, like I said, it's totally separate. Guys, I always tell you, monotonous work makes money. So your crews that are mowing don't need to be the ones going to do a commercial job. Your mowing guys need to mow, and your landscape crews need to landscape. Don't mix the two. So, but Pierce, I'll be looking for your email. And guys, any of you guys, if you want to send me job descriptions or job postings to ejones forsythtech.edu, I'll be glad to put that on our job board. That is my goal too, guys. I mean, I run a landscape business, and then I run the turf teacher, but you know, I am a community college instructor first. And so I want to place my students, to where I feel they're going to be a fit. I don't think, you know, I can't say, hey, you know, James, I want you to go here. I have to advertise those jobs to all the students and make it fair for each and every one of them. It's just like, you know, we're hiring a new lab tech at the college, have to make it available to all the students to apply for that. And that's a part-time position, 25 hours a week. But, you know, I want my students working for good companies. And then, you know, you guys that are following me and I'm following you, you guys are awesome. You guys are running nice landscape companies big time. And so thanks, Pierce, man. I hope my posts, sometimes I get a little crazy. That's still the military coming out in me when I start getting off track, and I have to keep reminding myself that I have to stick to turf post or landscape post on there. But looking forward to getting that email, Pierce. I see CC Property Maintenance joined. How are you tonight? Oh, Huntington Creek Landscaping. Where are you guys at? I'm doing good. Kind of sad there's no good basketball games on tonight. I love college basketball. So they'll start back up Thursday, I guess. Glad to see Danny Manning is staying at Wake Forest. Most of y'all know that Wake Forest is my team. I love the Demon Deacons, and I'm glad that Danny Manning is coming back next year. Keeping busy now. Spring is here. Posting like crazy. I see that. Love your post, man. I really do. That's awesome. I've had two crazy, hectic days yesterday and today. Was on campus yesterday about 5:45, and didn't get home last night till almost 7:30. So it was a jam-packed day, and then we got that rain late last night. Yesterday afternoon, I was out doing estimates in the rain and visiting clients, talking about upcoming jobs for them. So it was crazy. But guys, if you don't have any more questions for me, I'm gonna get off here. I've got several emails that I've got to return and phone calls. If you're interested, I'm doing a seminar in Winston-Salem, not this Saturday, but next, April 6th in Winston-Salem off of Haines Mall Boulevard beside Best Buy at the Hampton Inn. You'll get 7 hours worth of CEUs for your landscape contractor's license. You'll get 3 hours towards your irrigation license, and you'll get 3 hours of pesticide credits. It's called the Turf Talk Tour. I'm doing it. This will be the third time I'm doing it this year. Starting in June, we will be somewhere every single weekend doing the Turf Talk Show, helping you guys get your CEUs. We'll be in Raleigh again. We'll be, I don't have any, I'm LDN and X. LDN and X are the credits for the pesticides there. B. Jeetman. Zach, do you like the cab over track? Love the cab over track. That's the second one we've had. However, you know, it was a used truck and, you know, we got a deal in it. That's why we went and got it. But already had to take it back to Chevrolet place down in Mooresville. So they're having to do some work on it. They still under warranty. So they kind of messed up and they're very apologetic of it. But I do love the cab over trucks. It just makes it so much easier getting in and out of neighborhoods and not having to pull the trailer. Even though I love my trailer, but you know, I love the trailer for the landscape jobs. But when it comes to a mowing crew, that cab over truck is perfect. The V credits. I'm trying to think what that is. Are you meaning Virginia or are you meaning, or is that, I can't even remember what V is. Is that the is that aquatics, if I'm not mistaken? V credits. My classes aren't, they are L, D, N, and X. Any more questions, guys? I know it's getting close to 8:30. North Carolina, I'm not sure it showed up after I got into the storm water. I'll look into that. I'll call Mr. Weaver tomorrow and see. And I'll actually see if they'll certify. He was the one that actually certified those 3 hours for those courses. I wish I could do the pesticide classes online for you guys, but the North Carolina Department of Agriculture says no way. That has to be a face-to-face seminar because they need that signature. And I don't know why they need the signature, because once I have you guys sign the roster sheet, I come straight home and I key in your license number and your full name to post the credits to your account. And I actually just save that roster sheet in case there's an issue later on or if they audit me. But it would be nice if we could do the pesticides online. Are any of you guys irrigation contractors or looking to becoming an irrigation contractor? Or what about landscape contractor? I know the one thing that I'm working on right now is a pre-licensing course for landscape contractors. It's going to be 100% online. You know, we will go over chapter by chapter in the 3 textbooks that the board recommends to study for the practice exam. And then we will, you know, do a takeoff of a plan because that's all part of it. And then the plant ID portion of the landscape contractor's exam. The plant ID portion is all, you know, 100% online with the contractor's board. How's it going, Maxwell? Hardscapes. Like seeing the hardscape guys on here. Seeing some cool projects out there, man. But we will be working on the pre-licensing for the irrigation class. You know, even the boards, you know, asked me about doing something like that 100% online. State of Virginia's wanting me to do some pesticide credits for them. New Jersey's wanting some irrigation credits to teach. So a lot of things are going to start happening here at Turf Teacher. I'm actually having to hire employees for that side of the business. I've got 2 part-time people helping me right now in Turf Teacher. So, but Maxwell, where are you guys located? I I like seeing the hardscape companies on here. But, yeah, one last thing I wanted to say. I almost have a pre-licensing course for pesticide setup, and I can teach that online because it's not really sanctioned by the Department of Agriculture or the Pesticide Board. So, and basically the pre-licensing course for the pesticide license, we will do lectures, each chapter in both the core manual and the ONT manual. So it'll be specifically for ornamentals and turf. And then I have numerous questions that I will have in a test bank that, you know, you guys will have access to as long as you're enrolled in the course. And you can keep taking those practice test questions over and over again. So that will be finished up hopefully sometime 1st of June when we finish that up. But we've only got 29 more academic days in this semester, and then my load kind of lightens up a little bit, and I'll be able to finish that pre-licensing course. Plus, that is a course that I teach at the college anyway. So, HOR 164 Pest Management down in Mooresville. Good deal. Any more questions for me, guys? I've been on here almost 30 minutes. It's time to go return some emails and phone calls. It'll take me about an hour to do that. I had a lot of emails today that I need to return about the Turf Talk seminar coming up. So several asking about the April 6th date. And we'll be in Myrtle Beach in June doing the Turf Talk show. So if you're interested in that, I had a lot of guys asking about doing some courses in a place like Myrtle Beach or Wilmington. We're doing Myrtle Beach and Wilmington, doing Wilmington in July. That way they can kind of have like a mini vacation and take their families. So, but anyway, if you guys don't have any more questions, thanks for signing on. I love the questions and I love the comments, and I kind of want to build this portion up for you guys, doing this every Tuesday at 8 o'clock, and would like to know if you guys are interested in doing a mastermind group. And I've been approached by the John Maxwell side, one of his associates, to see about maybe doing this for you guys. We wanted to do the first session, no charge, to get 4 or 5 people to meet once a month for 6 months, and we come together. It could be 100% online. I would like the first session to be face-to-face, you know, maybe meet somewhere for lunch, and then we get set up and exchange each other's Zoom numbers or Skype numbers, and that way we could actually, you know, get together once a month and just brainstorm and help each other out and focus on being colleagues instead of competitors, because, guys, that's what we truly are. And that aspect we have to look at from our business standpoint. We are all colleagues in this together. And our competitors, those are the ones out there that are underpricing us, that are doing it the wrong way, that doesn't have any formal training, that doesn't have their, you know, pesticide license, that are out there doing large landscape jobs without their landscape contractor's license. So, you know, those are what I consider competitors. Each and every one of you guys are my colleagues, and I truly respect and appreciate what I learn from you guys. I learn something new every single day. And I tell my students that at the college, I'm like, that is the best thing about being in education, is because I still learn something every single day. The world of horticulture is so big that it's hard to know every single thing in the green industry. So I love to learn, but that's going to wrap it up for me, guys. I appreciate it, and I'll see you next Tuesday. Appreciate it. Bye.